And welcome back to Women of History, a channel where we talk about the women that our history textbooks forgot. It takes strength to stand up to a dictator. It takes an immense amount of bravery to speak out against a tyrant as a vulnerable youngster, especially when everyone around you is complicit and willing to tattle. But that's exactly what Sophie Scholl did. The fourth of six kids born to a stoutly Christian but strongly anti-Nazi politician, Sophie Scholl initially supported what she thought was Hitler's vision for Germany. But her understanding of the dictator was about to change soon. As a young girl, Sophie just wanted to study biology and philosophy. To fulfill the requirements for university, she worked for the National Labor Service and absolutely despised every second of it. But this is also where she began questioning her beliefs. She spent hours reading the works of theologian Augustine of Hippo, and with her relatives and boyfriend serving in the German military, she couldn't help but question the kind of Germany that Hitler was creating. Around that time, Sophie's father was jailed when someone overheard him calling Hitler the scourge of humanity. Her brother Hans, who was conscripted and had witnessed the treatment of Soviet prisoners of war and Jewish people, returned from service and spoke out against the Nazis, and was arrested for participating in a youth group that the party had outlawed. But that didn't discourage him, and if anything, it encouraged Sophie to join the resistance. In 1942, anonymous anti-Nazi essays started to pop up throughout the University of Munich. Three of the six flyers were signed White Rose, which we later find out was a name used to represent innocence in the face of evil. And these essays, or flyers, encouraged people to make copies and distribute them. Some sources claim that this was one of the first expressions of dissent against Hitler within Germany. But regardless, it caused quite the stir. Sophie, Hans, and some of his friends had purchased an illegal typewriter, which they used to make flyers and then made copies using a mimeograph. They'd then mail the flyers using stamps and envelopes that were difficult to get hold of in large numbers during a period of rationing. Sophie in particular played an important role in spreading the flyers, since she was less likely as a woman to be randomly checked by the SS. Between 1942 and 1943, the flyers reached across the country, asking the German people, "Why do you tolerate these rulers gradually robbing you, in public and in private, of one right after another?" Until one day nothing, absolutely nothing, remains except the machinery of the state, under the command of criminals and drunkards. White Rose's effort didn't stop with flyers though. Graffiti with phrases like "Hitler the mass murderer" appeared all across Munich. And by January of 1993, they were working like a well-oiled machine, sparking debate throughout the country. They even had the Gestapo believing that the White Rose had locations throughout Germany. And thus, a search was initiated to find the publisher of the flyers. Unfortunately, on the fateful day of the 18th of February, this search was successful. White Rose had brought a suitcase of flyers to spread throughout the University of Munich, and they had some leftovers, so Sophie took a whole bunch and threw them over a railing into a central hall. And while doing so, she was spotted by a janitor who told the Gestapo. On 21st February 1943, a mock trial was conducted, in which the judge essentially acted as a prosecutor, hurling insults at Sophie and Hans. The siblings took full responsibility for their actions in an attempt to save their friends. During this time, Hans and Sophie's parents tried to enter the courtroom to be there for their children, but the guard simply told them that they should have brought their kids up better. On 22nd of February 1943, Sophie and Hans Scholls were found guilty of treason and sentenced to death. And by 5 p.m. that day, they had breathed their last breath. Aged 21, Sophie Scholl's last words were supposedly, "What does death matter if through us, thousands of people are stirred to action?" After Scholl's death, copies of White Rose's flyers were smuggled out of Germany and given to the Allies, who dropped millions of them around the country. When World War II ended, the Scholl's verdict was overturned. And today, a square at the University of Munich is named after Hans and Sophie, and streets and squares around Germany after the members of White Rose. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, turn on notifications, and leave a comment with women that you think people should know about. And I'll see you next time with more Women of History.